With all the school closures going on around the world, you're no doubt going to be worried about your children's continuous learning needs. I've tested out 7 online learning sites that parents can use for elementary students without the need of any teacher or classroom passcodes and are user-friendly. So stick with me and I'll walk you through them. iXL is available in multiple countries. Just click on the down arrow to choose your country and the website will display your country's curriculum. The website is super user-friendly to use and everything is broken down by grade and also broken down by math and English arts. You're not required to sign in or register on the website. However, if you do want to use any of the real-time diagnostics or the analytics, you may need to register for that. But to use the website and all the activities, there is no need. Hovering over the links gives you a quick preview of what's included in each section. So this saves you time clicking in and out of each section, trying to find something suitable to use. Clicking on a particular grade gives you a breakdown of all the activities that are included in there. There is a recommendations page, also broken down by grade. Curriculum tab will give you a breakdown of the curriculum by each grade. And you can also print this. Again, hovering over the links will give you a preview of what's included. This is definitely one of the easiest websites to use, but it is limited to only math and English. But I do like that I can print the curriculum to PDF and I can just follow the curriculum as a guideline. Scratch is a really amazing website for young kids to learn programming. So there are two sites. One is for 8 to 16 year olds, and then you have Scratch Junior, which is from 5 to 7 year olds. I'll put the links below in the descriptions for all of these sites that I'm sharing with you today. So with Scratch, you definitely want to watch a couple of the tutorials to see how to get it to work. Even parents can try this out. I think it's just a really cool website. I wish I had known about this before. And I think kids would really be interested and it'll definitely keep them busy for a while. There are so many languages to use for this. You can also click on file and save it to your desktop, save it to your computer. So yeah, definitely want to check out if you want to get your kids' creativity going or if they love programming and coding. PBS for Parents is another user-friendly website. You don't need to sign in or register to use any of the activities here. I like how they break everything down by age and then by category. It's very easy to find something to do. So the website mostly has fun activities, if you will. These will be great for the times when you can't get your kids to focus or they just need a break from all the intense work. They have everything from arts and crafts to making recipes. And it's really easy to follow. They break everything down step by step and they'll tell you what materials are needed. So this is definitely one to use for those times when everybody needs a break, I think. Math Games is another one used in multiple countries. Click on the flag to scroll down to your country's curriculum. This website is as it is, it's purely focused on mathematics. It's very easy to use, everything is broken down by grade and by category. You can also find activities by using the standard method or the curriculum method. So under the standard tab, you'll see everything broken down by skill. If you don't sign up to use the website, then you'll just have to watch a couple of the adverts. Otherwise, it's totally free to use. I did try to print some of the worksheets out. You can see a preview here. There's also a link here that you can share with anybody if you want to. You can click on the curriculum and it'll tell you what's included in this activity. And I did try to download the worksheet. It tells me that it's generating and it's downloading, but because I didn't sign up for it and I don't have membership, it won't let me download any of the worksheets. So that's the only downside to it, but that's totally fine. So still definitely want to check out, especially if you want to improve on math skills. Brainpop is providing free access to all family members during the school closures. Scroll down to the bottom and you'll also see other links where you'll also be granted access. Click on the request free access link or button, click on free family access, and here you'll need to complete this access request form. So they have stated here 30 days access, but should the school closures be longer than 30 days, you should still have access to using the website. So once you've completed the access form, you'll get immediate access to all of their other Brainpop websites as well. So just choose whichever topic you want to use. I'm going to click on science here. Let's click on animals. Let's click on fish. So when you want to do the activity, you may be asked to just sign in again using the username and password that you use to set up. I really love this website. I love how everything's broken down. There's a lot more activities and topics going on. So you have your science, you have your math, English, social studies, everything is included in this. Now the thing I love about this website is that you can choose one topic, but it can have multiple activities within it. So you can write about the topic, you can draw about the topic, you can cover multiple competencies and skills just around one topic. Activity. Thing is, I don't recall seeing it broken down by grade, but it's rather broken down by subject. So you'll have to see which subjects activity your child is able to do. And because it's free right now and they cover a lot more subjects, I think I'll probably switch between using Brainpop and also iXL. But like I said, I'll be including links in the description below. So please let us know in the comments below whether you've used any of these websites before, whether you have any experience with these websites. And if not, then let us know which ones you find useful or which ones you plan on using. So Scholastic is another one that's providing free access to everyone during school closures. The only thing is the website does say that they are experiencing high volume, so you may find it to run a little bit slow. So this website would be perfect for reading time or a little bit of a story time. It doesn't really have a lot of activities, but it's still a good one to keep in mind. And also National Geographic Kids has a ton of step-by-step guides on how to do experiments, so this one will definitely keep your kids busy too. I really hope you guys found these useful. Please do leave me a comment below and give me a thumbs up. Please also subscribe for more videos. I want to take a moment to wish everybody the best during these difficult times. Stay healthy, stay safe. We will get through this. We just have to be positive and be strong.